subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Unacademy is providing courses for TS, MCET and AP MCET. They have specially started Telugu batches exclusively for Telugu students. So get subscribed so that you can access their entire courses. And this course will be available for the students for both PCM and PCB. And here is the schedule clearly, and there'll be separate doubt clearing session as well. So to this entire slide, and there are also other similar batches, comprehensive batches and etc etc. So just go through all these slides. Students, if you are Unacademy Plus subscriber, you will have multiple benefits. You can access premium content at affordable prices. You can attend regular quizzes for your self-analysis, and you can also attend full-length mock tests and test series. There are also multiple plans available. There is 12-month plan, 6-month plan, etc. The 1-month trail plan is for ₹2,250. You can use the code BESTWAY20 to get additional discount. It is live now. Students can attempt practice test for absolutely free of cost. You can just go through this page and register for Unacademy Plus. Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. We are in one of the videos where we will be discussing top 500 questions for physics MCET. These 500 questions which I'm going to explain you are the most important questions. So now let's begin this video and solve this problem without any delay. Okay, so coming to the question. Dimension of resistance in an electrical circuit in items of dimension of mass M, of length L, time T, current A would be what? This is the question. Dimension of resistance in an electrical circuit in items of dimension mass. Okay, here mass is denoted with M. Mass M. Okay, there are different items of dimensions. And what are those items of mass M? Mass is denoted by M. Length is denoted by L. Time is denoted by T. Current is denoted by A. Okay, so all these four things we have denoted with a letter. Mass M, length L, time T, current A. Here they are asking us what is the terms of dimension of mass, length, time and current. Okay, so now we need to find this. So now let's see how can we find this. Okay, to the first statement, resistance. We know there is a formula for resistance. What is the formula for resistance? The formula. Okay, let's solve the problem. So, the formula for resistance is potential difference by current. Potential okay. So, now let's see what is the formula for resistance. We are denoting resistance with a letter R, and the formula for resistance is potential difference by current. Okay. And we all know potential difference is denoted by V and current is denoted by L. So, which can also be written as W by QL. Till now, we have derived the formula for resistance. Okay, so now let's see what is dimension of R. Resistance, we have denoted it with letter R. The formula for dimension of R is dimension of work by dimension of charge into dimension of current. Put the formula for dimension of resistance, which is dimension of work divided by dimension of charge into dimension of current. Now we are substituting. Coming to the numerator, डायमेंशन ऑफ वर्क, डायमेंशन ऑफ वर्क कैन बी रिटन एज एम एल स्क्वेयर, दैट इज मास इनटू लेंथ स्क्वेयर इनवर्स ऑफ टाइम. व्हेन वी आर डिस्कसिंग विद द डायमेंशन ऑफ वर्क, देयर मस्ट बी मास, देयर मस्ट बी लेंथ एंड देयर मस्ट बी टाइम. ओके, सो वी जस्ट रोट द फॉर्मूला इन न्यूमरेटर साइड एंड नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाट वी नीड टू डू विद द डिनोमिनेटर. कमिंग टू द डिनोमिनेटर, इट इज dimension of charge into dimension of current. Dimension of charge can be written as current into time. So current here we have denoted current with A and we have denoted time with T. So I'm explaining again. So coming to the dimension of charge, so be written as current into time. We have denoted current with A and time with T, so we are just multiplying it. And last but not least, dimension of current. Okay, current, we all know current is denoted by A, so here we are directly writing it as A. Okay, clear till here? Now we are just simplifying this thing and we are writing it as ml square and T power minus 2. We have another T in denominator which will go to the numerator side and becomes T power minus 3. Now we are just left with A and A, okay, which is 1 by A square, and denominator A square goes to the numerator side which will become A inverse 2. And this is the final answer. Okay, so like this we need to solve the problem, and this is one of the most important problem. So yeah, hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss future videos from Best Way to Study, and also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more such kind of videos. Thank